In this video, I will be showing how to use the Find Identification Resources tool from the Library of Identification Resources project. And the basic idea is that, say you have found an animal or a plant or a fungus, for example this shield bug here, you want to be able to identify it. So you need an identification key or reference word, but how do you go about finding that? And how do you know how suitable such a resource is when you find it? So in this case here we have a shield bug from the Pentatomidae family. And if we go back to the tool, I can actually fill that in, the scientific name, and add the approximate coordinates of the location. And then, in this case, take a checklist from the catalog. So if it was found in the Netherlands, for example, you might want to use this Dutch resource about shield bugs. So if we then press search, you get a number of results. Over here on the right, we have percentages, and these indicate, based on the checklist, how many species from that checklist are actually included in that key. And if we then click, we can see there's actually only one species that isn't in the key, and that's Isacoris aeneus. Yeah, this looks like a good result, 97%. It's a key. It's for adults, and again, this is an adult shield bug. So if we then click on the result, we get more information. So we get this publication is for all Pentatomidae. It's originally for the region of Ukraine, but for the Netherlands, it's also suitable as we just saw based on the checklist, and it's a key to species, so it's not a key to genera. And at the time of writing, it was considered complete. And then we also have bibliographical info, so we have the author with a list of other publications in the database that they have written, and external links and languages they write in. We have the publisher, we have the series, we have the info link, we have a full text link, we have a link to the web archive, to the internet archive, and again the language of this publication. And then we also get a nice automatic full citation. Now, if you then want to go into a bit more detail about which species are included, we can click here on resources. So we have one and two, and in this case one is for the adults, as you can see here. And then we have a nice hierarchical interactive view of the taxa that are included in the identification key. We can download it as Darwin Core, and we have synonym information. We have a link to Anchor to things. We have a link to the GBIF page of the taxon, and we have a link to an information page as well for each taxon and a list of publications in which that taxon is mentioned. But then, actually, this shield bug is not from the Netherlands, it's from Switzerland. So actually this was wrong, we shouldn't have used a checklist from the Netherlands. And we don't have a checklist from Switzerland in the system. So what we can also do is generate a checklist from GBIF occurrences. So if I fill in the correct coordinates now, it will automatically see, okay, these coordinates are in Switzerland. It will then go to GBIF, to the API, and fetch all species that have occurrence records in Switzerland in the Pentatomidae family, and use that to compare the resources. And then we can see that the percentages actually change. So actually there's a few more species missing. And in this case we don't see the species names because of the GBIF API. But for example, Haliomorpha halis isn't yet in the Dutch checklist, even though it does occur in the Netherlands now, I believe. But the GBIF generated checklist does find it. And then if you go to another species, for example, Eurydema rotundicollis, which is actually probably the species that we see in the picture, does occur in Switzerland, but it doesn't occur in Ukraine, and therefore also isn't included in the key.